What's up, VC? It's Chris. Just want to come say, hey, what's up? I haven't had a lot of time to make record videos. Like I said, you know, it's baseball time, but it's game seven tonight, do or die, go home, us against Milwaukee. So if any of you guys are out in Milwaukee, I don't know, we'll see what happens tonight, right? Hey, and you know what? I got an idea. If anyone's a Milwaukee fan that watches my videos, which I don't know if you are or not, but maybe we'll do a little wager or something, you know, one record, you know, to the winner of the game or something like that. But I don't know, let me know. Anyways, this isn't going to be a record video. It's kind of different for me. I've never done a non-record video. It's going to be a concert video. I didn't have my ID with me. That's why I got next. But I went to a couple concerts over the last couple weeks. One of them was for my daughter, pretty much. But it was still fun. You know, we had a great time. It was Taylor Swift. So that concert we went to was at the AT&T Stadium, which is where the Dallas Cowboys play. So, you know, 60-something thousand people, 70,000 people. So she actually sold it out two nights back-to-back. So it was kind of crazy. But we got some, you know, hookups on tickets. My wife was in the Army. So every once in a while we get some, you know, free tickets for her being a veteran and stuff, which is cool. You know, she earned it. And all you veterans out there, I mean, you guys should look into that as well. I mean, it's definitely a cool perk and something all veterans deserve, I think. So anyways, the concert was great. Who opened for her? It was Charlie XCX, I think, which I think I've heard one of her songs, you know, on the radio or whatever. And then the second was this new girl, Camila Cabello, which is, she sings a Havana song that's on the radio right now. And they were okay. I'm not a big fan of either one of them, obviously. I mean, just pop music. I mean, Taylor Swift just puts on a great show. You know, I know most of her songs from my daughter playing them in the car. And I have, you know, two of her albums, I think. Or my daughter likes to listen to them, so I put them on. She's only seven. So, actually eight. Ooh. She turned eight last month. I'm sorry. She's eight. But, so, of course, after that concert, I had to go get her new album for her. You know, they wanted $40 for this at the concert, and I was like, yeah, that's not happening. Especially since I already paid $40 for her for a shirt. So, I went and got this online for $15. So, and it's kind of cool. It's a two LP picture disc, which is kind of cool. That's the other side of disc one. It's pretty neat. And, you know, picture discs, I'm like, I look for anything but a picture disc because they usually don't sound very good. I don't know how they, I mean, everyone needs to take note on this because this picture disc sounds fantastic. I mean, the bass that was coming out of my speakers and stuff, I mean, I don't know how they got their picture disc to sound better than other companies, but they did. So, that's pretty neat. There's probably about three or four tracks that aren't too bad on it. I don't really mind it, to be honest with you. A couple good songs, like I said. And anyways, let me show you a little clip here of the concert. Real short clip. Hold on. Enjoyed that little clip. I know, I'm sure not too many of you guys are big fans of Taylor Swift, but I just wanted to do a concert update. So that's when we went to. We had a great time, the whole family. And she puts on a good show. So, you know, is it worth maybe, what, $150, $200 they were asking for the tickets? Probably not. But, you know, like I said, we were kind of hooked up with them, for my wife being a veteran. So we went. It was a great time. And my daughter had our first concert that she liked. She's been to a couple concerts that we've dragged her to, like Weezer, and I think we took her to Jimmy Eat World. Incubus. She went to Incubus with us. But this is her first concert that she really likes, so that was fun. And then last night we went to another show, me and my wife, just us. And one of her favorite bands was in town, so I kind of surprised her with tickets. And that was Papa Roach. Maybe some of you guys have heard them. They're kind of a hard rock band. They have quite a few hits. Their main hit was back in like 2000. Their album was Infest, and it was called Last Resort. That was one of their hit songs and kind of jolted them to, a lot of people liking them. So, great show. Nice little venue. We were up on the mezzanine level, so I didn't have to worry about the mosh pit and all that nonsense down there. I'm too old for that, not even that old, but I just looked down there. I'm like, I didn't really want no part of that. So, it was fun. And I got an email like at noon yesterday from the venue and said, hey, you've been chosen for a meet and greet with the band. Do you want to go? And so I surprised my wife with that. We got to meet the band and got a cool picture with them. Let me show you. So that was kind of cool. I got to meet the band and everything, and they were super cool guys. We didn't get to hang out with them for a long time or anything like that, but it was still fun, and my wife was, starstruck, so that was kind of cool. She's got, I don't know if she got a crush on the lead singer, but, it's kind of the bad boy lead singer type that all the girls like, so. But he's like 42 now, so I'm not really too concerned about it. And anyways, but they had, some really great songs. The band that opened up for them was like Ashes to Something. I can't remember their name, but I guess they had some hits back in the day. They kind of sound like Linkin Park a little bit, one guy's rapping a little bit, and then, the other guy starts singing like Chester Bennington kind of did. So they were pretty good. It was different. They didn't have a bass player, but they had a guitar player and a drummer, and I think they had someone just laying down the beat a little bit, the keyboard type, backing. But they were decent, and here's a song by Papa Roach. It's probably my wife's favorite song that they do. It's called Scars, and pretty cool song. If you listen to the lyrics, it's pretty deep. You could tell he was writing it in like a troubling time, maybe broke up with somebody, or maybe a couple people, but take a listen. Scars, and I really enjoy that song as well. I don't know, if you listen to the lyrics, it just kind of, I think it can kind of relate to everybody. The scars remind us that the past is real. I tear my heart open just to feel. That's the the lyrics, the chorus, and you can't get rid of the scars of your past, and it just makes you who you are today. That's what I think it kind of means. And I think it's just a great song, to be honest with you. And, kind of heavy, kind of gets you, nodding. You can see the crowd kind of into it. The second clip I'm going to show you is, what's the name of it? I Think I Need Help, which is another one of their hits, later hits. But another great song, because, I don't know if he's talking about just his ego or or what, but he says, you know, I think I need help because I'm drowning in myself. So, I mean, I just kind of like listening to the lyrics. You know, I think he writes some great lyrics, to be honest with you, but take a listen. Just wanted to do a quick concert update. I never, you know, this might be my first non-vinyl video, to be honest with you. So, I don't know. Let me you guys know what you think. Maybe some of you guys have heard Papa Roach. Maybe some of you like him. I'm just kind of relaxing right now. I got to take my son camping here in a little bit. And, you know, just another busy weekend. It's raining every day here in Dallas. So, just listening to some Beach Boys Pet Sounds. Puts me in a good mood every time. So, hope you guys have a great weekend, and I'll get back to some vinyl videos, you know, I don't know, maybe after the World Series, hopefully, if we make it to the World Series. Anyways, go Dodgers. All right, see you.